My name is Michael French. I'm an artist and designer in augmented reality. I specialize and have an interest in kind of novel interaction patterns and exploring these frontiers that AR is offering us as creatives to explore right now. I'm especially interested in lenses and developing experiences as Lens Studio and the technology around it evolves. As a submission for the 2022 Dream It, Build It Lensathon, I created an education-focused lens called the Knowledge Pool, a location-based AR experience that lives at this fountain just outside of the Los Angeles Public Library's Central Library in downtown LA. I chose that location in part, at least conceptually, because when I think of the library and its mission, I think of our kind of collective aspirations toward greater understanding of the world we live in and knowledge, and also kind of the open access to anyone and everyone to that knowledge. But then when I went there to sort of look around and think about it, that's when I first saw that these fountains outside of the library that are the centerpiece of this big monument to knowledge are empty right now because of the drought and the library's civic responsibility of sacrificing some of the beauty of the monument in favor of water conservation. But the story behind them is still wonderful, and you can still honor their original purpose, but let them relate to the public again. In the lens itself, I tried to explore a series of bite-sized educational activities that a user, when they arrive there, if you look at this pool where the lens appears, it asks you to unlock it with a library card that you hold up. These educational activities are housed in this kind of bigger educational ecosystem where a user can kind of transition between these different experiences. If you conceptualize like what AR is in kind of the broadest sense, like a portal at the interchange between this giant like physical world and the giant digital world, and AR is a great sort of like portal in the middle of that. There are a couple of subject areas being outer space exploration and undersea exploration. And there are some activities around how you can interact with and understand some principles that then might excite you to learn more or to continue through the other experiences in the knowledge pool itself. You also get suggestions about library titles that relate to that or pathways to other ways to learn about this stuff. It's gamified to some degree by awarding these kind of achievement badges that are then attached to the user's library card. So if they leave the experience or go home, they still have through the lens this kind of acknowledgement of their achievements and those learning experiences that they completed. I started this lens with the custom landmarker template that allowed me to scan this fountain outside the library, get some mesh detail about it as a starting point within Lens Studio, and also determine the various kind of perspectives from which the user might approach the experience itself. Once that was established, I took pieces from the image marker template to use on the library card, establishing that as something that the lens would recognize to activate the experience. I had some physics features in there, some custom materials that I built using references from a number of templates, but all housed in this custom landmarker feature. Thinking about how the user understands what state the experience is in at any given point became a critical part of sort of planning the whole experience, always with this touch point of what experience I want the user to have, knowing that they will be wowed by the technology and that the magic of AR and that wonderment that comes from it, the more sophisticated and the more kind of lengthy an AR project becomes, the more you need to think about every move you make from the point of view of how the user will sense that, how they will know where to look when, always coming back to the user as the center of this experience. I would hope that when people interact with the lens, at the very least, I would want them to come away feeling that sense of wonderment that I think most of us have had when we've seen something, especially in AR for the first time, that we didn't know this was possible yet or this kind of thing. There's a lot that you can get from that simple initial moment of engagement that is helped by things outside of the traditional learning environments. I think AR's role in education in the future becomes this powerful nexus between these worlds of the physical and the virtual and the digital, creating that kind of interchange point between physical and analog learning and digital learning, and presents the power of both of those combined in a new expression, but doesn't try to replace everything that is also powerful in that ecosystem. Being a part of the Snap Lens Network community has been nothing but inspiration and positivity to me. But having that community there has totally changed the way I see my relationship to other people working in the medium. It's pretty remarkable the amount of kind of mutual support and mutual positivity and excitement that's happening in that community right now, and the speed at which the whole field is developing. To have that group of people there all cheering each other on and getting excited about each other's ideas. You see people doing incredible things that you never thought of, and you're like, okay, I want to do something like that too. You know, I want to stay part of this conversation. I want to offer something that they can feed off of. It's just a different kind of way to approach creative work. But always coming back to Lens Studio as sort of the heart of where the project is taking shape and where the magic happens.